New Jersey Chime Time, it is 4:11, and we are D&D, Deminski, and Doyle. I'm Jeff Deminski.
And
I'm Bill Doyle.
This is an absolute beautiful day, and an even better day to come to a home opener, Somerset Patriots, TD Bank Ballpark here in Bridgewater. That's where we are. We're going to be here right up until 7 o'clock. And we've got the man, Sparky Lyle.
This is kind of exciting, actually.
And, you know, Sparky, can I just tell you how pathetic our producer, Joe V, is here? Because, Sparky, we know you've been through these things a time or two. You know how to hold a microphone yourself.
I do, but I wasn't going to say anything.
But, right.
He holds it much better than I do. So.
But Joe, such a Yankees fan, and of course you're playing with the Yankees, he's just like,
thing.
Sparky, can I rub against your bicep, please?
Oh, is that what he was doing?
I think.
Okay. I kind of just dismissed that as a bump or something.
Inadvertent contact.
All right, the great Sparky Lyle. No, I don't have my notes with me. Did you play for the 67 Impossible Dream?
I did.
Was Carl Yastrzemski's Triple Crown year the best offensive season of teammate of
yours? By far and above. Yeah. When people ask me, you know, a lot of times people say, who's the greatest hitter you saw, you know, during my time? Yeah. I got to bring him up because there wasn't anybody that was as good as that guy that year. Mm-hmm. I mean, it was absolutely phenomenal. Plus, not only did he win the Triple Crown that year, but he led the league in assists also.
Nice guy to have control in the outfield.
Oh, yeah, he was absolutely tremendous.
And it was nice to see him get a little credit a few years ago when Miguel Cabrera won the Triple Crown, because then he started talking about Yaz, and he's kind of one of those forgotten guys who's in the Hall of Fame.
Well, right? I know, but it's been a long time since anybody's done that. I mean, holy man, that's it, you know, it's... He would come in and say, okay, get somebody on, I'll hit one out. I mean, just that nonchalant, and somebody walk or get a base hit, he'd hit one out, and we just kept on rolling. I mean, that's why it was the Impossible Dream, too. You know?
All right, and I won't dwell on 67, but Bob Gibson, 3 runs in 3 games, was that one of the better pitching?
Oh, yeah. And let me just back up a lot of things that people hear about Bob Gibson. He is that nasty.
Yeah.